In 1977, producer-director George Lucas created the Star Wars trilogy and changed the way we looked at movies. Now, 20 years later, using new digital technology, Lucas and his creative teams at Lucasfilm, THX, Skywalker Sound, and Industrial Light and Magic have completely restored, enhanced, and added to these classic movies to create the Star Wars Trilogy Special Edition. For the trilogy's second installment, The Empire Strikes Back, Lucas supervised the addition of brand new footage, as well as an enhanced look for many of the film's key scenes and locations.
Once I started to redo the first film, it became such a good experience that I said, well, gee, we should go back and finish the other two films too.
I'm not afraid.
You will be.
One of the problems I had is one of the sequences with the Wampa ice monster. The monster that was developed originally didn't work, so I had to jettison that monster. I had Phil Tippett create a little tiny hand puppet, which we were able to use in two shots. It was just a head. And we just did it at the last minute to stick it in. But the rest of the sequence was sort of cut around the monster, where you hear it, but you don't see it. And there's a certain creative way of doing that. I mean, you can do it where you don't see the monster. And some people would say that's more artistic than actually showing it. But in this particular case, I really wanted to see the monster. And I felt it would add more tension to the scene and make it more interesting. So we were able to do that. I was able to go back, create a better version of the monster, and shoot the scene and all the cutaways to the monster and add them into the scene, which I think makes that ice scene make more sense than it did before. The snow battle was a challenge when we did it, because nobody had ever done blue screen matting on a white surface. You usually do it on dark surfaces.
Here we go then. Action!
We used optical technology, of course, to do all that compositing. And a telltale sign that something's been optically composited is a black line around it. And when you have a sequence that takes place in outer space against stars, it's easy to reach a point where those black lines don't show up. But when you have a sequence that takes place against snow in the daylight, every hint of that black matte line becomes very visible. And so the first time through doing the snow battle here 17 years ago, a lot of effort went into finding ways to minimize that black line. One of the ways was to not print all of the elements at their full opacity.
All right, I'm coming in.
Consequently, when you see the snow battle on film, you may notice that there's part of the scenery is visible through the cockpit. And it was a constant trade-off of how transparent can we make the cockpit? At what point is the black line more objectionable than the transparency? And so there was an opportunity to go back into those shots, use the computer technology, and eliminate all the transparency, but also not have any matte lines.
The other issue was going into Cloud City. Cloud City was a very difficult thing to design and create originally as a floating city in the clouds. Some of the mat work there wasn't very good. And when they built the set, it's very confined. It's a very small set. It doesn't look out onto anything. It's just, you get this, it's a very claustrophobic kind of set. And that always bothered me. I wanted to be more open, see more of the city. And so what we've done is we've added to the approach of the city, similar to what we did with Mos Eisley in Star Wars. I mean, there's many more shots coming up to the city. You get to see more of the city. You get to see more speeders and those sorts of things. And then at the same time, when they land and they start walking through the city, now they walk through and there's large windows, you can see out and see more of the city, and it opens it up and makes it much larger. Be able to pull back and see these grand visions of balconies and the city beyond and all that kind of stuff. To do that before was almost impossible, and now we can do it. We're doing it, you know, we have moving shots, we have all kinds of things that they just weren't able to do before. They just was not possible up until a few years ago.
My ally is the Force, and the powerful ally it is.
Now, sit back and get ready to experience George Lucas's definitive vision of The Empire Strikes Back, the second installment in the Star Wars Trilogy Special Edition.